Greetings. This is the next video examining and answering some questions from Islam, part 2. In video 1 of this series, I laid out the 12 points of the message from the Islamic poster. Here are the first 4 points. Is a group of Jews stronger than your God? I already answered that one. If God died for 3 days, who was supporting the world when he was absent? If Jesus is God, then who is his Father? Is he also God? Let's look at point 2. If God died for 3 days, who was supporting the world when he was absent? So right away I would like to define died, because one of the most common issues for those taught by Muhammad's Quran are the flawed and incorrect definitions that Mohammedism applies to other religions. Mohammedism tries hard to control the discussion by demanding the definitions they want, while refusing to accept the definition by those who they are attempting to debate or misrepresent. This is one of those cases. Islam attempts to make a mocking statement based on a definition of died and the Islamic definition of Allah. And I would love for some Mohammedan with facts to post their definition. I'll provide my estimate of their definition later in this video. For the moment, I must give the Christian definition, first of all, to set the stage. Christianity believes that man is 3 parts, body, soul, and spirit. You are your spirit. God has revealed himself as a trinity of forms, 3 manifestations, or 3 persons. God has established this revelation by the prophets and their message, where God in one form speaks to or about himself in another form. The Word of God states God the Father is a spirit. Jesus existed in spirit with God before creation. When Jesus was born, his spirit was not created, only joined to his body. Your body is just the atoms of this reality which combine as your physical suit, for lack of a better term. The Christian definition of death could be colloquialized as your spirit leaving your body. Christians believe your spirit, once created by God, is now eternal. From the point of creation, your spirit will not cease to exist in the future. Your body is grown in your mother's womb, and at some point, God knits or combines or joins your spirit to your body. And here is where the Christian definition makes sense and is self-consistent. Death does not mean ceasing to exist. So when Jesus died, Christians understand his spirit simply left his body. He did not cease to exist. His body was wrapped and buried in the tomb. And the Word of God says he, Jesus' spirit, went to hell. And Jesus also preached to the righteous men who had died. Their spirits were in a place the prophets call Abraham's bosom. Jesus preached to Abraham and Moses and David and the other prophets and the righteous dead. And when God determined his justice and judgment were satisfied, God raised Jesus, pulling his spirit from hell along with the righteous souls. John 20:17. Jesus saith unto her, Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father. Ascended to my Father means that God the Father was on the throne through this whole time. You see, God the Father was sitting on his throne the entire time. And this is no problem at all, given God's revelation of himself. The message of the prophets clearly identifies God in 3 forms in the Old Testament. The prophets teach of God's Holy Spirit as a uniquely identifiable personality or form of God. I encourage you to watch my series about the Trinity. In it, I go into more detail of the many scriptures by the prophets that reveal the Trinity. If you can respect the definition of the Trinity that God revealed, the answer to this question from Islam is simple and obvious. But if you try and understand Christian teaching with Islamic definitions, it is like trying to read a book in French with only a Spanish dictionary. The letters will seem to look familiar, but the text will make no sense. I've already given you the Christian answer to the question, and Islam has a fundamental problem trying to grasp the concepts I have described. Because of the rigid and oversimplified definition of monotheism, Mohammedans have formed a static picture of their Allah. So let's read the question one more time and examine the implied Islamic thinking behind it. If God died for 3 days, who was supporting the world when he was absent? Usage of the phrase, "he was absent," is an important indicator of Islamic thinking. Absent implies he was not there, as if God is not everywhere. And it really is important to understand their functional definition of Allah, or God. The very phrase is based on the unspoken assertion that Allah can only be in one place. And this is one of those strange topics that Islam is two-faced about. Two-faced, as in presenting two completely different, contradictory images. Sura 2:115 is one surah and ayat I found offered as evidence that Allah is omnipresent, as Jehovah, the God of Abraham, is. But I find there is one problem with Sura 2:115. Of the 29 translations called generally accepted, only one translates Sura 2:115 as omnipresent, and one translates it as parenthesis omnipresent, close parenthesis. In parentheses, meaning that it is a translator extrapolation. The other translations claim Allah is infinite or boundless or all-pervading or encompassing or all-embracing or transcendent or munificent, all of which have very different meanings from omnipresent. So Sura 2:115 is in no way a clear definition of Allah as omnipresent. Keep that in mind as I describe Islam's Allah in a little more detail in general. Allah is separate from his creation. Some even say Allah cannot enter his creation. This is www.as-salaf.com. Ibn al-Mubarak, it was related that Ibn Shaqiq said to Ibn al-Mubarak, "How do you know our Lord?" And he said, "By knowing that he is above the seventh heaven over the throne, that he is separate from his creation." This is from www.systemoflife.com, articles, "Where is Allah?" He has a lot of verses, it's a very long web page, and he says, "Conclusion, the above verses of the Quran and hadith of Prophet and consensuses of Sahabas and Tabi'in clearly say Allah is not present physically everywhere by his self, but is present separate from his creation above the heaven and above his throne." And what does the Quran say related to this subject? Sura 67:16-17. "Do you feel secure that he who is fis-sama, above the heavens, will not cause the earth to sink? Or do you feel secure that he who is fis-sama, above the heavens, will not send against you a violent whirlwind?" In both cases, it says Allah is above the heavens. And this is continuing. It is important to point out here that the literal translation of fis-sama is in the heavens. The scholars of tafsir have explained it according to the Arabic language. For fi in this context to have the meaning of above, as it is not possible for Allah to be surrounded by his creation. This is one of Islam's explanations for what it is worth. And from missionislam.com, whereallah.htm, Suleiman ibn Abd Allah ibn Muhammad ibn Abd al-Wahhab, the Wahhabi founder's grandson, said, "Whoever believes or says Allah is in person in every place or in one place, he is a disbeliever. It is obligatory to declare that Allah is separate from his creation. This is another explanation from Islam, and it is pretty clear. Well, as clear as anything in Islam gets. He is not every place. Whoever says Allah is in person in every place is a disbeliever. Whoever believes or says Allah is in person in every place or in one place, he is a disbeliever. Look, I'm trying to give this as fair and honest and intellectual a treatment as I can, but it's just crap. What the Quran says is mush that no two Mohammedans can even agree upon. And if you look at the last statement, you are a disbeliever in both cases. If you say Allah is everywhere, omnipresent, you are a disbeliever. If you say Allah is only in one place, you are a disbeliever. Whoever believes or says Allah is in person in every place or in one place, he is a disbeliever. It is obligatory to declare that Allah is separate from his creation. And I think that statement must serve to sum up the Mohammedan mental image of their Allah. Allah is separate and above his creation, far away somewhere. But like the Santa Claus fairy tale, Allah sees you when you're sleeping and knows when you're awake. And he knows if you've been bad or good, then it's off to the fiery lake. If God died for 3 days, who was supporting the world when he was absent? So when a Mohammedan hears that Jesus is God and that Jesus died, his logic is predetermined for him. He must imagine if Jesus is Allah, and if he could be Allah, Jesus must be this separate, distant Allah above things. And if Jesus or Allah is dead, he is somewhere other than sitting on the throne. The throne must therefore be empty. As far as I can tell, this really is how Mohammedans come to the table. This is what they consider logic. And then when they ponder Jesus or Allah being dead, they cannot comprehend it. If Jesus is Allah, and Jesus is in hell, then Allah is in hell, and Allah is not above his throne. Then who is keeping the earth spinning on the turtle's back? Oh, wait, wrong pagan cult. But that is why you get this question and others like it. The overly simplified and overly rigid dogmatism of monotheism and Allah's distant separateness shapes their thinking and the mental model they have of Allah. And then they wrongly apply their Allah mental model to Jesus, the Son of God. The issue I find perplexing is that Islam's position almost argues that Jesus ceased to exist while he was dead. Although it really is impossible to get a Mohammedan to even define their definitions for any of this. But if any of you in Saudi Arabia or Yemen or Pakistan or Lebanon want to provide Sura and Ayat, let me know. I'll certainly look them up. But regarding this question, Islam has no way to even begin to analyze the Christian answer. And I'm surprised that not one Mohammedan has even ventured the idea that Allah can appear to be in two places at once. After all, they freely accept the Quran's tale that Allah made the whole crucifixion appear to be something other than it was. If God died for 3 days, who was supporting the world when he was absent? To summarize the correct answer, God the Father remained on the throne the whole time. And that really does make perfect sense to those of us Trinitarian monotheists. I'll get to point 3 in the next video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.